It's got what it takes to become the new landmark of Albania's capital, Tirana. The pyramid at the heart of the city. Every day, hundreds of locals and tourists climb up it and enjoy the view from the top.
It's wonderful here. I'm usually not good at climbing, but I made it up here.
It would be great if there were an elevator up here for us old people.
It's totally changed here. I still remember what it used to look like, but now, really beautiful.
Because the pyramid was the landmark of Tirana once before, 35 years ago. It was inaugurated as the Enver Hoxha Museum and dedicated to the former dictator of Albania. Hoxha was a Stalinist whose brutal reign lasted over 40 years. Fatos Lubonia was one of tens of thousands of political prisoners at the time. The pyramid, he says, was a symbol of oppression and is now a symbol of modern Albania's historical ignorance.
Look at this nice Belvedere. You go up and you see Tirana out of it. But there is not the shit of it more. And when I mean the shit, I mean the symbol of the dictatorship.
At home, Lubonia shows us what he means. Lubonia's father was a functionary in the Hoxha regime before he fell out of favor. The whole family was forced to atone.
We were accused for agitation and propaganda against the regime, four people, and we were arrested, and the family was sent in deportation.
Lubonia was a prisoner of the Hoxha regime for 17 years. He spent most of this time doing forced labor in the notorious Spach prison.
This is a remaining of a light, to make light, somehow, lamp, for we used it in the mine, you know.
Spach was like a Stalinist gulag, hell on earth, survival under inhuman conditions. Almost all books were strictly forbidden, apart from dictionaries, which Lubonia used to hide something that would later make him famous. His first book, written on cigarette paper during his incarceration, in miniature script.
Left to me by a friend.
Lubonia is now a writer and artist, and a critical voice in Albania. In his view, the renovated pyramid is an attempt to erase the dark history of communism in Albania.
No one can, among the new young generation, come here and find a trace of the past.
Quite the opposite, says architect Gentti Agoli. While planning the new pyramid, the Dutch architects in charge were always concerned with making the past visible. The most important change is found on the stairs.
People should feel like they are conquering the pyramid, symbolically opposing communism and dictatorship.
Again and again, the building's history is revealed in various places.
This is the old part that it's only painted and it's rough that to show the history of the building.
In the new pyramid, everything revolves around the future. Colorful cubes built into the vast space house the TUMO Center for Creative Technology. Young people can learn to implement their ideas here using state-of-the-art technology. Anyone can take part here, and it's free.
I've already done a few introductory courses at TUMO, and I think I'll continue. I see my future in technology.
Tutors also lend a helping hand. In the workshop next door, a project is nearing completion. And it's not about computer games, but about Albania's dark past.
This is a graphic design class at TUMO, and we're working on a project about Spach prison.
A project about, of all things, the prison where Fatos Lubonia was held. Perhaps Albanian youth are not as oblivious to history as he fears.
It's important to understand how was it? How was created this evil? And how we suffered it so much because of this evil? How? in order not to repeat it, as I said.
Something they seem to be working on in the new pyramid.